tonight. From Raymond James Stadium in Tampa, Florida. It's a special prime time edition of the NFL on EA Sports. See Tom Brady and the Tampa Bay Buccaneers taking on Dak Prescott and the Dallas Cowboys.
We are just a few miles from the Gulf Coast of Florida at Raymond James Stadium here in Tampa. Just a short time ago, the Buccaneers emerging from their tunnel to the roar of this frenzied crowd here in the Sunshine State. And we're in the big ship, and fittingly, everyone here ready to do battle as Tampa Bay gets ready to match up with Dak Prescott and the Dallas Cowboys. Tampa. This is Tony Pollard. And makes it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. Now we'll see what the right arm of Dak Prescott has in store as the Dallas Cowboys offense sets up shop.
It's been a lot of fun watching him advance in his career. Many people question his ability to throw the football coming out of Mississippi State. He's conclusively answered that question. In addition, a very strong runner and an even better leader.
Prescott looks to throw on first. He's got Wilson, middle of the field. 5 yards on the game's first play, second down. Prescott. Man open, that's complete to Dalton Schultz. And they're able to get this one across the 35.
And that's a more than acceptable read right there because it's zone coverage, so timing is everything. This time he waits for his man to come open, puts it right on him, and they pick up a first down.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Out of the gun, here's Prescott. And there is Amari Cooper, his first catch. And able to rip off a big chunk of yardage before being dropped inside the 40. So Amari Cooper out of Northwestern High School in Miami making a nice play there.
And it's so funny that when I was going through the draft process when he came out of Alabama and was inquiring about him and his skills, they say it all began back in Miami. He really became a pro receiver at a young age because of his attention to detail and precision. But don't forget his athletic ability. That's what made that catch there.
And he did spend 1 year with Teddy Bridgewater as his quarterback there, so that helped back in high school. And again, it's Prescott over the middle, hauled in by Lamb. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, second and 2. I don't think it's a surprise they're throwing the football early. We expected that. They told us they were going to come out firing, but 4 for 4 on the opening drive. They like that.
They don't just like it. They love it because now everyone gets locked in. Your confidence jumps up. Everyone's easy about what they're doing out there. And by the way, they're looking at the sidelines thinking to themselves and expressing, Let's keep throwing it. We're doing pretty well.
From the 30 on second down, Prescott. And down he goes, a Buccaneer sack. The defense rising to the challenge and setting him back on the sack.
Enough Texas start to have a good drive, quite like a big loss on a sack, does it?
Now they're looking at a third and long, and suddenly the momentum shifted to the other side of the football.
And old Mo is a very, very fickle man.
They'll need a big play here. Will Dak and the Cowboys after the sack. It's third and long. From the shotgun, it's Prescott. He'll fire deep downfield from Lamb. And that will be incomplete. Well, they weren't scared to let it fly, but it falls to the ground and brings up fourth down.
Well, that play was certainly a little bit different because on the previous play, he was sacked. This time, protection a lot better, had time to survey the field, and still couldn't find an open receiver.
On fourth down, here's Brian Anger now to kick this one away. And this will be out of bounds. Now it's a question of where they'll mark it. And they'll say it crosses at the 11-yard line. Tampa Bay coming out along with a man who needs no introduction, the great Tom Brady.
Well, we've all seen what Tom Brady can do on a football field for a couple of decades now. But how about his most impressive accomplishment? Moving to a different franchise and taking them to a Super Bowl title as well. Not many players can continually stiff-arm Father Time the way that he has.
Brady and the Bucs now with a first and 10 at their own 11. Fakes the give to Fournette. Now Brady. Oh, he's going to take a shot right away. And this is, oh my goodness, he pulled it in one-handed. A big play that time for Tampa Bay.
I don't think we'll ever get enough of watching one-handed catches, and when they pay off, they are spectacular. But how about the times they don't pay off and coaches go, two hands still works.
I know, but they go for them so often now that I'm almost starting to take them for granted.
Yeah, that's unbelievable, isn't it? Because these are sensational type plays.
Especially that one with a defender right there. So how about this for a change in field position? From inside the 10, here's first down on the other side of the field. Here's Brady. Into the hands of Darden. And he gets it down a yard or two shy of the 30 before he's out of bounds. They'll contain him to just 4. Second down.
Never make the mistake that the slot receivers, especially the little guys like we're watching here, are just quicker than fast. A lot of them combine quickness and speed, and they catch a lot of footballs, as we just saw there.
6 yards left on second down. Play action. Now it's Brady. And a first hookup with his all-pro tight end, Rob Gronkowski.
Well, there it is, partner. Brady to Gronk. Their first connection of the game.
You think those two often in sync?
I don't think there's any question about it. And look, we know Gronk has a whole lot of fun, but he's deadly serious about his football, as is Tom Brady. Two great competitors, two fantastic players.
Now Brady again. Over the middle, complete. It's Johnson. A gain of 6 there on first. And forget about the run to set up the pass. They're just coming out throwing.
Forget trying to set anything up. They feel like they have the advantage. They feel like they have the matchups, and they're just attacking right now.
Yep, going to the air on the opening drive. From the 17, here's second and 4. Now Brady. Open man is Howard, the tight end.
And the tight end is certainly positioned built to move the chains because they can control space underneath. If they've got good hands, then, of course, they're a dynamic target. But one other thing is they're right in the sight lines of a quarterback on just about every play, and that makes it easier for the quarterback to pick him out and deliver.
On the ground, this is Leonard Fournette. And they'll go backwards here, losing yardage to the 14. Call it a full 3 yards in the wrong direction there. Brings up second down. Bear in mind, that wasn't a big lineman back there for the tackle for loss. That was a cornerback.
So are you saying the myth has been shattered? That all of them are not just cover corners? Some of them actually will stick their nose in and tackle when necessary? That's what we just saw, isn't it?
That loss of three, a rare stumble on a promising drive. Here's second and 13. Here's Brady to throw. And this one too low.
It's been a good opening drive offensively thus far, but you know they don't want to waste it and settle for a field goal attempt after that incompletion. So this is a big play coming up here on third down.
Seventh play of this drive coming up, but a long way to go on third down. Now Brady. Throwing left side, he's got Gronk complete. And they'll get him down about 3 yards short of the first. They pick up 10, but it'll still lead to a fourth down.
Nice job understanding the situation. Third and long, kept the play in front of them and made the tackle. They gave up a good chunk of yardage, but it does force a fourth down.
So Brady departs, and on it's Ryan Succop for the Buccaneer field goal. From the left half, should be a fairly easy one here. And Succop will put this one right through, and the Bucs take a 3-0 lead. So a long drive gets them down inside the five, but ultimately they settle for just the field goal.
And I have to think that if maybe they were a yard closer, that would have made their decision tougher, and I think they likely would have gone for it. But in this situation, they just decided to take the three, and I think it was a smart move.
The punter Pinion now to kick this one away. Now Pollard. And out a little across the 25 to the 27. Second drive forthcoming here for the Dallas Cowboys. They punted last time they had it. What steps, Charles, you think they have to take to make sure they don't do that again?
Well, let's just go to the football 101, the trite expression 101. Win first down. Make 5, 6, 7 yards on first down and make it a second and 3, second and manageable. Keep accumulating first downs that way. Keep moving the football. You don't want to get behind the sticks because then the defense has the advantage.
So Prescott and the Cowboys now with a first and 10 at their own 27. And he'll manage to pick up about 4. It's second down.
Well, the end of all that hitting and hollering, it was a 4-yard run, so the offense is going to go back to huddle and feel pretty good about themselves. Defensively, you have to feel okay because you didn't let it turn into a bigger run, but the goal, shut it down for 2 yards or less. That's when you start to feel good about yourselves.
Now a second down and 6. Prescott from the gun, and this one quickly to Lamb. Starting drive number 2 off on the right foot. Completion for the first down. Drive 1 is that had to be pretty frustrating because they moved the football. They just didn't get any points out of it.
But warm-up QB 2, let's bring in the backup. I mean, my goodness, you take them downfield and you don't score points. You know I'm being totally facetious here, right? I'm just kidding. Nice first drive. Rarely do teams score on every single drive in a game. But they like what they did there. They just hope they can pay it off this time with some points.
And nothing much materializing there on the first down run. He'll get a couple, and that's it.
Certainly a nice job there by the defense, rallying to the football and getting him on the ground. But I think the play gets made by the defensive front because if they can't get upfield, Their job is to go ahead and get low, almost get into a ball sometimes, stack things up, and make it difficult for the runner to find a hole.
On second down, Elliott once more. It'll be a gain of five, but still about 3 yards shy of the first down marker, and now it's third down.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent gain.
And the Bucs with an extra defender in the secondary now on third down. They'll try and run for it with Elliott. Well, they hit him in the backfield, and he will not escape. And that is not going to get it done. A loss of a yard, and it brings up fourth.
Sometimes in the run game, you can make the argument that quickness beats size. And how about the example right here?
Here's Brian Anger now, as he'll punt it away for the second time. And that hits at the six and carries into the end zone for a touchback. Tampa Bay, they're getting ready to set up shop here for their second drive. They've got a 3-0 lead and the football as they start first and 10. Now Brady. It's complete. He's got Gronk. And he'll be tackled at the 23 after a gain of three. I think defensively you're okay with that. You're in the first quarter. He's going to get some catches, but they rallied to him quickly.
And that's what you count on. And I like what you just said. First quarter, can you do it all game long? They catch it, you tackle them, they go down on the spot. Because when you're able to do that and you don't give up big chunks of yardage after the catch, now you put the offense in a position where every series they have to work hard to pick up first downs, and you tend to stall them out when you do that.
Call it a gain of five there on the run, but they'll remain a yard or two short here with third down coming up.
All right, Brad, I know we're in the early going here, but those kind of runs, they're going to open up a world of opportunities for this offense going forward.
A couple extra tight ends in the formation here as they line up third and two. They'll try and run for it with Fournette. And he's able to get it to the 33. Good enough for a first down.
I know the game's changed. A lot of people would say it's evolved. Look, I'm a little bit Neanderthal, okay? I love this. No exotic formations, no misdirection. Just line up and run the darn ball, pick up the first down. I love it.
Yeah, third and short, that's what you're supposed to do. Like you said, old school smash mouth football. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. Brady. And this one caught by Cameron Brady. 5 yards on the catch there. Brings up second down.
Nice rhythm throw there on first down. He located his tight end, made a nice easy pitch and catch.
Hoping he can break a tackle or two. Wasn't able to do that there, but still good yardage. From the 38, Brady. It's caught by Mike Evans. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. Thank you. 3-0 after one on EA Sports. First downs on the drive already as they'll go from the 47 now on first down. Throwing now is Brady. A pass underneath for Fournette. And able to break one tackle but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain. So the completion good for seven there. And that'll make it a second down. To Fournette. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. Although his reputation as a speedy runner precedes him, it's always fun to watch him work.
It is eye-opening, isn't it? Because when you see him get the ball and just go, in addition to that speed, it helps out his blockers. They don't have to hold blocks for long because he's just going to speed right past them.
So a good run by Fournette. Now another first and 10. Now a handoff here to his running back. And he won't get much. Maybe a couple. Down inside the 35 to the 34.
Oh, that's a real nice job there by the defensive front. They just engaged and held their ground. But how about the guy who made the play? We often talk about whether they take a good first step or not. Many times you just don't take any step. Just get your feet moving, get your body going. And then once he made the read, he was able to make the play.
Meanwhile, Brady's throw pulled in by Gronkowski.
Oh, it's time to give a little credit there to the defense. They played that very well because it was a drag route. And he ran a little shallower than normal as he worked straight across the field. He was hoping he'd get lost behind the defensive line. But once he made the catch, nowhere to turn upfield and gain any yardage.
An eight-play drive to this point. So here's play number 9 on 3rd and 7. Brady's throw there, incomplete. This Cowboy defense looked ready for that third down pass. Brings up 4th. So Brady departs, and on it's Ryan Succop for the Buccaneer field goal. The wind is at his back here in the second quarter. Succop's kick is good, and they're able to double their lead in this first half. It's 6-0. So scores on their first two possessions, but 6-0, so field goal is probably not what they were hoping for.
Yeah, you're exactly right about that. Not what they were hoping for, but they should be happy that they have points on the board. It almost feels like that old slow and steady wins the race, doesn't it? In this case, though, they want to be slow and steady now, but get explosive later and put the points up on the board.
The punter, Pinion, now to kick this one away. On the return, Tony Pollard from his end zone. And able to take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. The Dallas offense back out onto the field. They've had it twice. They've punted twice. Not the start they were hoping for.
Not at all. And let's face it, every facility we visit, everyone talks about converting on third down, how big that is. In this situation, they've had to punt it away twice, so they're furiously going over things on the sidelines. What do we need to do to pick up a first down and change our momentum?
So Prescott and the Cowboys now with a first and 10 at their own 28-yard line. He'll hand it off to Elliott to begin the drive. And to the 36-yard line, taken down there after getting 8 yards.
Even though they gave up more than they wanted to on that play, it actually illustrates how well they bottled him up throughout the game because that was his longest run of this contest.
8 yards the tally on that first down run. Here's 2nd and 2. The give is to Elliott. And he'll bring it up here to right at the 40-yard line.
Looking into his prime time for a little bit of a gamble, isn't it? Open up the playbook, go play action, toss that bad boy deep. But in this situation, go ahead and give it to your back. Let him pick up a first down. Keep the sticks moving.
First down, Prescott. That is caught by Lamb. Now he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35.
Well, that certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle, the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Looking to throw, Prescott. Buying time to his left. Oh, Prescott stripped.
Much like a running back going through the line, quarterbacks have to be aware of protecting the football as well. He left it exposed that time, wound up having it knocked free, but fortunately, had an alert teammate who was able to get it.
A kicker fest so far, all points via field goals. They're hoping to change that right here. Here's Prescott. Flushed out right. And the stop will come inside the 5 at the 4.
Well, he did a nice job keeping his eyes downfield, waiting for someone to get open. But once the pressure forced his eyes down to see the rush, it was time to make a break for it.
Second and goal from inside the 5. Dak going to hand it to Elliott on the option. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. Ezekiel Elliott taking it in from 4 yards out. And the Cowboys are now just an extra point away from moving out in front. Now Greg Zuerlein on for the extra point. He's got it, and they take the lead at 7-6. That time a 6-play drive, and it culminates in a touchdown run by Ezekiel Elliott. Now after the touchdown, it's Zuerlein. He'll kick it away. And here comes a return from just beyond the goal line. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23. Now the Buccaneers offense gets ready to head back onto the field. And fortunate to get points on the board last time. They had to hit a really long field goal to do so.
The kickers in today's game are so good and so skilled and hit from distances that we almost start to take them for granted. Mm-hmm. And we can't do that. That's a long field goal that they got 3 points out of. They've got to feel good about that. And they better make sure they love him up because he's helped them out.
Yeah, now we'll see if that offense can put 6 on the board here. We'll see. Brady now on first down. this will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down.
He did a fine job there of not hitting it before the ball arrived, and I've got to tell you, you can often mistime that play because of the angles of approach. When you're going to get him, sometimes you panic as well and think, I've got to be there right now. Instead, in this case, timed it perfectly and knocked it free.
Brady's throw complete there to Johnson. And he's brought down, getting this one up to about the 35.
But one of the ways the quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. To throw is Brady. And he will go down. A Cowboys sack. Osa Odigizawa. What a play by him. That's going to go as a loss of 13. And partner, it's safe to say that the secondary really contributed to that sack.
Yeah, nickel set, five defensive backs. They covered everything. Nowhere to go with the football. But my question is, why didn't he throw it away?
Now then, after the sack, it'll be interesting to see what they have planned for second and 23. Brady now to throw. And he'll get that to Fournette, complete. And he'll get this up past the 25 before he's out of bounds. They'll wind up getting seven on the play. And they're going to be staring at a third and long here. Brady going to throw. This is caught by Evans. And he gets this to the other side of midfield across the 45 before going out.
That's a play that will likely be forgotten when you talk about big moments in this game. But plays like this are critical to keep drives going. And if points result, we'll call this play significant.
Pretty decisive. He brings out that red challenge flag. Did he keep those feet in bounds? That's the question they've got to decide. And I got to say, watching it in real time, it was awfully close.
Yeah,
it
certainly looked like a heck of a catch because he didn't appear to bobble it, which could complicate things. But even with the benefit of replay, that's pretty tight.
Well, here's the call. So not successful there on the challenge, and he'll have to be careful from here on out because he'll only have one challenge remaining. Brady now on first down. And the timing a bit off that time as that one falls to the ground.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. Here's a give to Fournette. They get seven out of that, so they're left with a third and 3.
That was a really nice run there to bring up third and short. After the incompletion on first down, it's awfully nice to have a running back that you can hand it to and put you back in a good situation.
The Bucs on third down. They've hit 2 for 4 thus far. This time it's third and 3. Now a first carry for Giovanni Bernard. Well, this is going to depend on the spot, but it's not a very generous one. He looks to be about a yard or so short. He needed two, he got one, and that's going to leave him with fourth down and a yard.
Well, we talk about defenders, specifically linebackers, keeping their eyes in the right spot. He had that eye down the entire time.
And you know that's not easily done because they throw a lot of misdirection at you. They try and fool you and get your eyes in the wrong place. But you're right about that one. He correctly figured that one out and made a really nice play.
Would have been right at about a 52-yard field goal try, but no, they are going to go for this thing on fourth down. A carry here for the big tight end. And he gets it to the 32. Good enough for a first down. Good spot on the field to go for it. Kind of no man's land, as they call it, and it worked out.
Yeah, they call it no man's land because your punter is telling you it's too short. I'm just going to punt it into the end zone. Your field goal kicker might give you a little raised eyebrow. Might be too far for the field goal. So it gives you a great chance to go for it. Personally, if you have those tendencies to be aggressive as a head coach, you kind of like this spot because it gives you the decision to go ahead and go for it when you want to anyway. From the snap, he certainly looked like he knew where he wanted to go with the ball, but surprise, that guy was covered. So that took his attention elsewhere to no avail.
Second and 10. To throw, it's Brady. He'll check this one off to Fournette. And he is out of bounds inside the 30. Ali Marpet, the guard, caught there. Temporarily out of field goal range now as they come up on a second and long after the holding call. Looking to throw. Brady. It's complete. It's Miller. If they didn't have that penalty a moment ago, it'd be a first down. Still a nice 13-yard pickup. Third field goal of the first half, not what they're looking for as they come up on third down. Operating from the gun, Brady. And this is going to be incomplete.
They went with the dime look that time on defense, just flooded the field with defensive backs, blanketed everyone, took away all the passing angles, thus the incompletion.
So Brady departs, and on is Ryan Succop for the Buccaneer field goal. This one from 46 yards out. And Succop will put this one right through, and they jump back in front here. It's 9-7. So that one is his third of the game. Now, if you're wondering, that's only halfway to his career high, as he once had six field goals.
Brandon, six? Let's hope we don't get that again, please. Okay, can we see a few touchdowns here and there?
That'd be nice. The punter Pinion now to kick this one away. Pollard elects to keep it, and this will come out to the 25-yard line. Amari Cooper and the Cowboys set to take over once again. They've got to be thinking, how can we get him a little bit more involved here? Second quarter, you're down, and really, he's been out of the mix.
I would agree with that, and oftentimes you hear, well, we're just taking what the defense is giving us, but sometimes that's just not good enough. Sometimes you have to take what you want, and that means getting him the football.
Yeah, so far just a single catch in this game. So Prescott and the Cowboys now with a first and 10 at their 25-yard line. They start on the ground with Elliott. And he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down.
Well, that's just a pile of bodies there, and that's when you kind of find out who's a tough guy, right? Who can stand up and make a play? It was only a 3-yard run, but for both sides, they had to walk away from that feeling like, okay, I can can stand up when the going gets tough in here.
On second and seven, Prescott. Oh, the Buccaneer pressure too much. Down he goes. Shaquille Barrett put that sack by his name in the stat sheet.
Pressure can come from all over when you're plotting a defensive strategy. On that particular play, it just came from the outside.
They'll need a big play here. Will Dak and the Cowboys after the sack. It's third and long. Now Prescott. And that is incomplete. 2 minutes remaining in this first half of football. Here's Brian Anger now. As the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. He's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. And a fair catch taken back near about the 35, 36-yard line. A 40-yard punt, no return, and the Bucs will get ready to go on offense. Leonard Fournette and the rest of the Bucs offense set to take over once more. A good job in the passing game, decent job in the running game, but really they've been more effective through the air. We'll see if that shifts at all as this goes on.
Thus far, it feels like they're calling this game in reverse. Normally, you run to set up the pass. Here, it feels like they're passing, hoping to set up the run and be more effective later on in the game.
Yeah, you can do it both ways. We usually talk about it in the reverse, however.
No doubt about it.
So, good starting field position for them here as they come up first and 10 at their 36-yard line. Throwing to start the drive. Brady got his man complete over the middle. That's Johnson. And down he goes at the 45 after a pickup of 9.
Fired that one in there, able to make connection on a nice in route.
With those faster passes when they're going that fast, any hesitation as a quarterback that the deflection, if you miss, might be bigger and lead to an interception?
Yeah, and the deflection works both ways. Maybe a defender gets a hand in the way and it pops in the air, and sometimes you throw it so hard your receiver can't handle it, and he pops it up in the air for the defenders to grab as well.
But a moot point there as they were able to connect. 2 yards the loss, and now they go from second and 2 to a tough third and 4.
Partner, when you see a screen pass and the defensive tackle ends up making the play, you know that one wasn't sold well at all, because he should be upfield by the time you throw the pass. If not, you end up with big trouble, as we just saw right there.
And on third down, the Cowboys bring in an extra defensive back. Back to throw. Brady. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked up by Leighton Vander Esch. And he takes this one back into the end zone. And the Cowboy defense has a touchdown. Charles, I'm looking at you, and understandably, your mouth is wide open in disbelief. What were they thinking?
That's going to be one of the great mysteries, but I do know this. When they went out on offense, I will guarantee they told them, don't just make anticipatory throws. Make sure you see it before you throw it. Didn't happen here.
Trying to protect that lead, and now they gave it up. Now Zuerlein on to add the extra point. And the lead is up to 5. A heck of a play there defensively, getting the interception, navigating his way into the end zone for the touchdown.
So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away. This fielded right at the goal line. And he'll be stopped up at the 25. Well, the Bucs going to take over now late in this first half. And with a little under a minute remaining, we'll see if they want to try to put a drive together, possibly even take the lead here with a touchdown. To try again after the pick six. Over the middle, that's taken in by Gronkowski. Now the Bucs going to use the first of their timeouts as the clock stops here with 46 seconds remaining in the first half. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Looking to throw, Brady. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
To this point, I've been impressed with the work defensively. They have not allowed a lot of receivers to run free. And there's another example, another incompletion.
Here's second and 10. Throwing again, Brady, and Gronkowski's got it, complete over the middle. The Bucs going to go ahead and use the second of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 35 seconds to go in quarter number two. And the Cowboys here on third down bringing in an extra defensive back. Again, they'll throw with Brady. And the Cowboys' pressure gets there this time for the sack. The Cowboys going to use their second timeout now as they get it right at the 32nd mark of this first half. So on now is the Clemson man, Bradley Pinion, to punt this one away. CeeDee Lamb deep for the Cowboys. That'll be a 43-yard punt, just a single yard on the return. And the Cowboys will take over the football with a first and 10. Amari Cooper and the rest of the offense heading back out there now. Second quarter here, he has only one catch, but they have the lead. You got to think there was going to be more involved at some point.
That's what you would expect, but sometimes what defenses do to take away a player of his magnitude, it costs them in other areas. And right now, with them losing, they may have to change their focus, and maybe he will open up a little bit more as the game goes on.
Yeah, well, so far, just the single catch. A first down throw for Prescott. A hit as he throws there, incomplete.
Certainly appeared to take away his first read, and by the time he tried to look elsewhere and find an open target, the coverage was too good. That one falls incomplete.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. Not wanting to take a chance this time, they'll keep it on the ground. And he'll push forward here for a good little run as the clock continues to run. They get six. That'll leave them with third and four. So we have reached halftime here with the visiting Cowboys out on top. As we toss it an hour or so east of here to Orlando, it's Jonathan Coachman with our EA Sports Halftime Report.
Okay, Brandon, thanks very much, and welcome everyone to this abridged version of the EA Sports Halftime Report. Okay, Brandon, thanks very much, and welcome in everyone to an abbreviated version of the EA Sports Halftime Report. Halftime Report. This game's had a little bit of everything thus far, and certainly plenty to look forward to as the teams are right back out there for the second half. So we'll get right back out there as well, as we'll turn it back over to Brandon Godden.
Okay, Coach, yeah, adjustments likely going to play a big role in this third quarter in what's been a tight contest so far. So this just a five-point game as we resume action in this second half on EA Sports. And we will not see a return to start the half as this will be a touchback. Out come the Buccaneers. They'll have it first to start in the third quarter. And they're on the short end of the scoreboard here. Charles, what adjustments, if any, do you think they need to make for the second half?
We're paraphrasing the gold medal hockey winning coach Herb Brooks. I just say you continue to play your game. Throw the ball. They had success doing it in the first half, so make sure you keep getting the ball to your playmakers, a little bit more to the perimeter perhaps, but above all, play your game.
And Brady and the Buccaneers here, first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. Throwing to start the drive, Brady. And that's incomplete.
We've got to give out a little applause on that play. It has to go to the defense. More good work by them. They've taken away the passing lanes all game long, and you can see the frustration that it's causing because he just about threw that one into the first row.
Following the incomplete pass, here they go again, second and 10 from the 25. Back to throw, Brady, and Miller with it over the middle. And he's taken down but able to slip across the 35. Scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. From the gun, Brady. They'll swing this out to Fournette. And this winds up a gain of four to the 41.
I know it was a gain, but you have to sense probably a little bit of disappointment there because when it's out there in open space, I think they expect to get more out of a play, don't you?
Especially when you're getting it to your guy out of the backfield. You're expecting him to be able to create something, be a little more shifty.
Yeah, no doubt about it. Good open field tackling held it to an okay game.
From the 41, Brady. That's complete to his running back, Evans.
I think it all came together there. In-breaking route. Drove it with excellent pace. Money throw right there to move the sticks.
Couple of first downs on the drive already as they'll go from the 47 now on first down. And that'll be accepted, of course, and that moves him back five. Now they need 15 yards on this series after the delay of game. First and 15. Again, it's Brady. And he will go down. A Cowboys sack. Neville Gallimore. Give him the credit for the sack and a loss of 14 yards.
I think that time he just maybe held on to it a little too long, CD, because after a couple of seconds in this league, you know those defenders are coming.
And how many times did we talk about complementary football? And we usually talk about, does the offense help the defense? Does the defense help the offense? I think in this case, does the quarterback help out his offensive line? You only have a certain amount of time to get rid of the football. they can only do so much. On this play, he took them to the limits.
Now this one from about two counties over after the sack. They come up on a second and very long. And only able to get two here, stopped at the 30.
Well done to sniff that out defensively. He had it diagnosed pretty quickly.
I love that description because diagnosed is perfect on that one. Read his keys, made the play, and he couldn't even get going moving the football.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. Gets it to his running back, Bernard. And he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 34 here. He did his best to just get four out of that, but not enough. And now fourth down.
How about that strategy there, Brandon? Third down. They just said, we've got faith in our tackles. We'll give you the short stuff. And just decided to protect the sticks. So every time I hear fans telling me tackling's not a part of the game anymore, plays like that, I can clip and save and show them you have to tackle well if you want to be a good defense.
Here's Bradley Pinion now as he'll kick it away for the second time. 46 on his first kick, this one in that neighborhood as well. A 41-yard punt there with no return, and out will come the offense as they take over. The Cowboys offense now, they head out for their first possession of the second half. So Prescott and the Cowboys now with a first and 10 at their own 21. They'll try and start this drive in the air. He'll find Lamb. That's complete. And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39.
As they began this drive, I was wondering how they were going to attack since they're playing with the lead. Would they continue to try and push the ball downfield? Well, after one play, it appears that the answer is yes.
From up near the 40 now after the big play to start. Here's another first and 10. 10th carry now for Elliott. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. 47 yards rushing for him now on what was his 10th carry of the ball game. A tough run by Ezekiel Elliott, the fourth overall pick in the 2016 draft.
If you watch tape of him in college, you saw plenty of those runs because I know the highlights showed him in the open field breaking away from people, but that's how he wore down defenses, those exact type of runs.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. They keep on the ground with Elliott. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and four.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
The last run got six, now second and four. They play fake to Elliott, now Prescott. He'll get this out wide here to Elliott. And this is going to lead to another first down as the tackle's made at the Bucs 28.
Caught that look from you there, partner. I think we're on the same page on that one. Just his first catch. I think we both thought he'd be a little more active in the passing game. Let's see if that's the start of them trying to get the ball to him a little bit more here in the second half.
And inside the 20 before he's brought down.
If you want more carries, I think we saw how you get them. showed that he's got the fresh legs, and he picked up the first down on that run. Don't just ask for him. Show him that you're supposed to get the football.
So from inside the 20, here's first and 10 at the 18.
They stay on the ground, but this time it's Elliott.
And he'll take it from the 18 to the 15, a gain of 3.
We know that old expression, it's not my night. It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough go for him.
And every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. That was the same case on that play.
On second and 7, Prescott.
Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back, complete. And he's going to be brought down just shy of the 5 and the 6. So they will accept the penalty and move forward.
So a critical mistake roughing the passer. Now it's first and goal. Dak's going to keep it.
And he'll get blown up behind the line of scrimmage. Back at the 6. That's going to wind up a loss of a full 3 yards on first down.
Sometimes you just sit back and marvel at what he can do defensively. Speed, strength, quickness, he's the whole package. And that package just wrapped up the runner for a loss.
Second and goal from the 6 this time.
They'll try the right side with Elliott. A nifty move on the run, but ultimately stops short of the goal line down at the 2.
Give him right around 4 on the carry. We'll see if they want to keep pounding here on 3rd and goal. 2 straight shots on the ground. Now on 3rd, do you go to the air?
I think the possibility exists, and if you're doing it, you're probably going play action since you ran it twice. But I often think that 2nd down is the time you go play action, throw the ball. I say commit to the run and think about it being 4 down territory.
And Elliott trying to work his way forward, but it looks like he did not make it. What a stand so far defensively, and now that's going to bring up a 4th and goal.
Prescott. And that is caught. Touchdown, Cowboys.
Cedric Wilson there to make the grab. And the Cowboys, they push out in front further.
That seemed pretty ideal there for the offense, Charles. You take a little bit of time off the clock here in the 3rd quarter, decent length drive, and you pad your lead as well at the end of it.
And what it does is let you feel like you're in control of this game, even more so than a 2-touchdown lead, right? Because you've taken that time off, as you noted, which means they couldn't get you off the field. You ran your playbook the way you wanted to, and you gave your defense some rest. What a big-time drive in that situation.
Zuerlein connects on the extra point, and it gives his guys a 12-point advantage.
Now after the touchdown, it's Zuerlein. He'll kick it away.
From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end zone. And ultimately, he stopped right where he would have been if he had simply gone down to a knee at the 25. Here comes the Tampa Bay offense now heading back out onto the field and hoping to do better than they did their last possession when they punted the football.
Appeal to the vanity of your offensive line. Tell them that they control your fate. Leverage guys. Win the line of scrimmage. If you do that, you start to win first down. You win second down. And guess what? You start accumulating first downs. And that's what they need in order to not punt the ball again.
Brady going to bring the Bucs up with a first and 10 at their 25-yard line. Throwing to start the drive. Brady. Oh, and this ball's tipped and intercepted. Picked off by Micah Parsons. And he takes this one back into the end zone. And the Cowboy defense has a touchdown.
It goes without saying, but I'm going to say it anyway. That's a ball he would like to have back. And it lands right in the lap of the defender from there. He doesn't have very far to go before he gets to the end zone. And he got there in a hurry.
Zerline now for the PAT. And that one makes this a 19-point game. So the defense creating some points, not only getting the interception, but then returning it to the end zone for the pick six. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. And there will not be a return here. It's a touchback, and it'll come out to the 25-yard line. Now the Buccaneers offensive unit back out on the field. And they gave up the pick six, and now they'll be looking to right the ship here. Now, as a quarterback, are you a little more cautious this go-around?
You should be, just because after what you gave up. But you can't be so cautious as to just really take things in and now you're not going to play loose enough to give your team a chance to score. But you still have to be careful because those defensive guys, I know the reputation defense guys can't catch. All evidence to the contrary on that last possession, though.
Well, now a throw here secured by his running back out of the backfield. And up to the 35 before they're able to knock him down.
Another catch for him there on this drive, Brandon. And it looks like they're going to utilize him out of the backfield any way they can. And that time, they pick up a first down. So now on defense, do you assign a man to him and try and cover him before he gets going?
Fournette, a first down carry. He'll be dropped shy of the 40 despite powering through the tackle. Give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and six.
Well, on every play call, you realize it's not going to go for a touchdown. So a lot of your calls are setting things up for maybe later in the game, trying to establish the inside run, run with toughness now, hopefully get to the perimeter later. And let's face it, you could do worse than a 4-yard run on first down.
Second and six. Here's Brady. He's able to find Miller. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40.
Well, we talk all the time about playing situational football. Right now, I think the scoreboard is dictating what they need to do. Where they are in this game, they've got to push the ball downfield, take their shots, try and get big chunks of yardage in a short amount of time. That was a nice play there.
So from Cowboy territory now, here's first and 10 at the 42-yard line. Now Brady to Evans on the slant. And he's going to get this inside the 30.
much better from this offense, because so far in this game, no touchdown to this point, and what's usually a direct correlation? Very few explosive plays. That's been their issue, not able to make that big shot downfield or break one off, but a nice game there for a first down.
First and 10, here's Brady. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Johnson. 3 yards the gain there, second down.
That's now 4 completions in a row. A good bounce back following the interception last drive.
Certainly not letting it affect him, that's for sure. And we all know interceptions are going to happen. So the big trick, don't let it affect you going forward. Most of the good quarterbacks, they just tell the ball boy, get that one out of the rotation, give me a fresh ball. And let's go. He's got his offense moving again.
From the 24, Brady. Miller on the catch over the middle. And he's going to have another first down here as the tackle's made at the Cowboys' 12-yard line.
And this has been a nice answer to the touchdown drive against them a few minutes ago, because they've come out and reestablished the tempo. A nice throw there, and they're putting together a very strong drive as a response.
From down at the 12, it's first and 10.
Now Leonard Fournette. And he stopped immediately there. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down. 3 quarters have come and gone. This is the National Football League on EA Sports. Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again, second and 10. Play action, now it's Brady. And Evans hauls it in, touchdown Bucs. Mike Evans, there to make the grab. And the Bucs are finally into the end zone here in this fourth quarter.
So a little bit of a letdown there defensively. I mean, look, you're still 2 scores to the good, CD, but things may be a little more uncomfortable than they had hoped.
Yeah, if you kept them at the end zone there, this game's over. You've locked the door on them. Instead, it's still open a little bit, and they've got a puncher's chance.
Ryan Succop on for the point after. And they're able to cut the deficit to 12. So that one, an 8-play drive. It spans 75 yards. And it ends with a touchdown for the Bucs. Following the touchdown now, it's Bradley Pinion on to kick this one away.
This one will come out to the 25 as Pollard is going to elect not to return it. Dallas offense set for this next drive.
Well, there are 2 scores on the plus side. Still time here in this fourth quarter, but maybe you start thinking about playing keep away?
Yeah, I think here's the situation. You're not thinking touchdowns anymore. You're just thinking first downs. To keep up with your theme there, playing keep away, first downs, they can't touch the ball.
So Prescott and the Cowboys now with a first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. Looking for Cooper, that's complete. And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line.
Another nice pickup through the air, and I think a lot of people might expect him to run the ball in this situation, Brandon, but with this lead, they're electing to throw the football. Swings, slants, quick outs, things that they consider safe.
Play
shouts from this crowd as they watch the replay. They want a challenge, and they're going to get one. Did he keep those feet in bounds? That's the question they've got to decide. And I got to say, watching it in real time, it was awfully close.
Yeah, it certainly looked like a heck of a catch because he didn't appear to bobble it, which could complicate things. But even with the benefit of replay, that's pretty tight.
Now here's the call.
After reviewing the play,
the challenge there does not go their way. This will indeed remain a completed pass. Here's a second and two now from the 33. Off play action to Elliott. Here's Prescott. A dump off to Elliott.
Well, that should be a reminder defensively, and I think it's a reminder to myself because you just can't sell out to stop the run. There's still enough time that this offense can move the football through the air, even on first and second downs, and they obviously picked the right spot to throw the ball there.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. Play action now, Prescott. On the crossing route, he hits his man, Amari Cooper, and able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down.
Partner, I like that they're staying aggressive on offense because, to me, this drive is what is known as a put-away drive. You score here, that might put this one to bed. I like the fact that they're playing with confidence and not playing with fear.
A first down carry by Elliott. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and nine.
I'm sure that that's going to be the formula. Just keep the ball on the ground. Keep that clock moving.
And when you have the lead this late in the game, above all, stay in bounds. Yes, take care of the football. Yes, gain yardage, but stay in bounds and let that clock tick.
On second and nine, Prescott. Oh, that'll be incomplete. Oh, he took a shot as he let that go. And it's going to bring up a third down.
But listen, when you've got the lead, there's absolutely no sense trying to fit a ball in where you shouldn't. You can see the coaching in his head taking place on that play because he saw he had a receiver in the area. He just put it well over his head, out of harm's way.
On third down, it's Prescott. And he'll go underneath here to Elliott. And they'll bring him down right at midfield, and he is well short of the first down. 3 yards, all they could muster there, and it'll bring up fourth down.
So much about this game is just understanding situations and then having to execute, isn't it? Guard the first down sticks. Don't let them get there, and they rallied and made the tackle.
Here's Brian Anger now. He'll boot it away from about his 35. They'll call that a 33-yard punt with no return. And the Bucs are going to take over first and 10 deep in their own territory. And Tampa Bay trots out there now.
Well, still a long way to go, but trending upward. They scored the last time out, you remember. Then their defense forced the punt. Now they try to inch closer, but still ultimately down 2 scores in the final quarter. Brady and the Bucs now with a first and 10
at their own 13. Throwing to start the drive. Brady. A good pick up there. 8 yards on the first down completion. Fourth quarter, every drive so critical, and you figure may only get one more shot after this, so a touchdown's imperative on this drive.
It is, but you also have to think to yourself, if play calling, don't hold anything back. Don't save it for the second touchdown. You got the first one for the second one to even matter.
Ahead of the chains now, second and two. Now Brady toward the center of the field, but it's incomplete.
Receiver coaches preach to their guys all the time, separation. That's what's going to make the play successful. That time there was very little, and I think they were actually fortunate that it was only knocked away and not intercepted.
The Bucs on third down. Not so hot. 2 for 9 to this point. Here it's 3rd and 2. From the gun, it's Brady. Johnson with a completion over the middle. And he is going to have a Bucs first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
All right, this is the time of the game where they're down a couple scores, and they've really got to get some yards in chunks, and they know the defense doesn't want to give those up, but they've got to find a way to take them anyway.
Now the question is, can they string a few of those together?
Scrimmage, the 37 on 1st and 10. Now Brady. He finds his target. It's Evans. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down.
You cannot write these guys off just yet. Not with a quarterback like that under center.
You mean it actually crossed your mind with him running the team that you could actually maybe write this game off?
Not yet.
Not a chance. Not with him. We've seen it too many times.
Two first downs have him up near midfield now on 1st and 10.
Going to
set him back 5 yards. The delay of game backs him up 5, 1st and 15. Here's Brady to throw. He's going to drop this one down to Bernard. That catch good for only a couple.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
Now Brady again. He completes it to Evans. And this will be good for a pickup of 9 to the 46. The Bucs on third down. They're hitting at just 30%, 3 for 10. This is 3rd and 4. Throwing now is Brady. There's Evans again, complete. And he is going to have the Buccaneers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
And in a two-score game, obviously, every play, every third down, like we saw there, magnified, big pickup.
It was a huge pickup. What they really want, though, is to not even get to third down. They've got to maximize time and conserve as much as possible.
Of scrimmage, the 37 on 1st and 10. Brady to throw again. And a catch right side by Evans. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20.
Good yardage on the completion there. When they look at the scoreboard, they do understand a field goal is not going to do them any good. My guess, they're going to press the ball downfield as far as possible, try and throw it into the end zone and get a score, because they know they've got to get that done and get the ball back as quickly as possible.
So the ball down to the 16 here for 1st and 10.
Okay.
So a little bit of a stiffer challenge. First and 15 following the delay of gain. Brady now to throw. Dumps it off to Fournette. They'll contain him to just four. Second down.
And that's a good job there by the corner. We do talk about this a lot, that a lot of corners see their job as simply covering receivers. Tackling isn't everyone's thing. But in this case, he came up quickly and made a nice, sure tackle.
Looking to throw again on second down. Brady over the middle to Evans. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down.
One of the feature points of the end route is being able to make a nice throw to the middle part of the field. And for a quarterback, that's one of the better throws and better looks that he'll get. But he has to be careful not to wait too long and let his receiver wander into some tough territory. If he's late with the ball, he can get his receiver hit and hit hard.
Brady. And he's got it. And in for the Buccaneers touchdown. Tyler Johnson, an 11-yard touchdown. And the Buccaneers have made it a one-score game again here in the fourth. Well, time to let those folks know who are tuning in looking for the late local news. And we may be a moment because we've got a game again.
And partner, except for those on the West Coast where it'll be seen in its regular time, right? That's the way it works, doesn't it? But how about that? Big-time drive right there. If they're going to have any chance, they needed a touchdown there, and they went right down the field and worked their way into the end zone.
Extra point put through by Suckup, and now things get a bit more interesting here in this fourth quarter. With a kickoff honors following the touchdown. Now Pollard. And they will wrangle him down a couple yards shy of the 30. And now Dallas gets set to take the field. This game has really flipped on its head. Two unanswered touchdowns by the other side, and now yeah, they take over here with just a very slim one-score lead.
And we've seen this how many times now? Teams get a big lead, they go into coast mode, and all of a sudden they're scrambling and battling for a win down the stretch. They've got to put something together right here, otherwise they're in danger of doing the old snatching defeat from the jaws of victory.
They'll start the drive with Elliott, and he can only manage to get a couple. Second and 8 coming up.
So fourth quarter, a nice run there to start this drive. Charles, what do you think the split will be here between run and pass?
Well, partner, I think it'll lean towards the run, but this is also not a time where you just totally do that. You still have to possess the ball, move the sticks, and keep the clock moving as well. So they'll run their offense, but yeah, when they have a chance to run it, they'll do that a little bit more.
Dak dropping this one off for Zeke. And he gets this up across the 35 before he's out of bounds. So 8 yards on the completion there, and that'll bring up what looks to be a third and inches. Can't be more than a half a foot. Prescott to throw it. And it's caught over the middle. Wilson. And he will have a Cowboys first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
And that pickup of a first down, that's going to leave a mark because they really needed to stop them there, didn't they?
So frustrating. Defensively, you're a play away from getting that football back here down late. Tough.
Now they've got to find a way to create a turnover or takeaway. Otherwise, this one will probably get away from them.
tonight for the workhorse, Elliott.
And he'll take this ahead for about four. Second down coming up.
And in this situation with the lead fourth quarter, they're liking keeping the ball on the ground, I'm sure.
That's just smart football, but you know the defense has to know it as well. They've got to stop them here. So now we're going to see that loading the box in a big way. 6, 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take, puts a little bit more pressure on your big offensive line.
Meanwhile, Prescott's throw complete into the hands of Schultz here.
That one good for the completion percentage, but no gain. It'll be third down.
As a defense, you're more balanced when you're in zone coverage because you're able to keep your eyes on the quarterback and see the play develop in front of you. They're able to keep the quick pass in front of them and stop it right at the line of scrimmage.
One of the bigger plays in the game thus far. The crowd getting into it as we come up on a big third down. From the shotgun, it's Prescott. Over the middle, complete. That's Schultz. And he will have a Cowboys first down. They needed five there on third down. He winds up getting seven.
Couldn't just sit on it here, could they? Had to throw the ball on third down. Got the big completion in the pickup. Fresh set of downs now. They've got to feel great.
And defensively, a backbreaker. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. Out of the gun, here's Prescott. And look at this, they get the turnover they needed, it's intercepted. Picked off by Sean Murphy Bunting, and the Bucs are right back in this football game. So it's Buccaneer football as we welcome you back. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that. They had a great air attack going. Do they stick with it?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing because that drive went and went, no adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
Meanwhile, Brady's throw taken in by Evans here.
And this will be good for a pickup of 9 to the 46.
Nice, well-coached, a team that understands what's going on. They still have time to work the middle of the field as they just did there.
Clock running, the Bucs try to go quickly and get set. Now Brady, open man, Gronkowski complete. Very sharp here to start this drive, 3 for 3.
Yeah, I like the way he's running this 2-minute drill. Very sharp, very precise in throwing the football.
First down now, but the clock continues to move. Back to throw, Brady. He completes this into the hands of Miller. And he works it past the 30, almost to the 25.
Hardy, got to like what they're doing right there. Little by little, they're getting closer. Another good pickup.
The Bucs going to go ahead and use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop it with a little over 30 ticks to go in the football game.
This one complete to Darden.
Yeah, this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down. So 5 plays on this drive, Charles. All passes, all completions. And just like that, they're in the red zone.
And don't you think the playbook opens up a little bit more now? Because all they've done is throw the football. If you want to run it now, you may very well have them fooled.
Just a yard to go here on second down.
To throw is Brady. And that is incomplete. So 17 seconds now on the clock here.
Now we're in the situation where the quarterback's got to take full charge of his helmet. Got to totally command and make sure all eyes are on him. All focus is locked in. Going to call multiple plays and go over different situations and scenarios to make sure everyone is on the same page.
Back to throw. And he comes back with one complete. And the Bucs are going to have a first and goal coming up as they find a way to convert there on third and one. Well, Charles, exciting to the very end. That's what we just saw in this game. Final play there, had it in the red zone, but anytime you're outside of the 10, that's tough trying to draw up a final play to get in, and they couldn't do it.
It certainly is. So what they were looking for was, you know, extra time. Too bad it's not FIFA soccer, right, where you get a little bit of extra and you get a chance to run them a couple more plays and maybe get closer and take that last shot into the end zone.
So that'll just about do it for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, log on to easports.com. With that, we bid you good night from Tampa.